Now, KSBW Weather Plus with Jim VanderZwan.
Well, we have to pull out just a little bit to show you what's going on. Close-up satellite would show you nothing because there's nothing in the sky right now. No low clouds, no high clouds. All of that's way upstream there, so we ended with a beautiful day. And as expected, got a little bit warm. 92 in Boulder Creek, 91 in Scotts Valley, 90 in Ben Lomond. And then 86 turned out to be the one of two records for Santa Cruz, or a couple more up in the Bay Area. It was 85 in Watsonville. A little cooler air, but a lot warmer than what we've had lately, where we're doing 50s and 60s. We got 70s today, all the way up to 70. 78 in Marina, 73 in Carmel by the Sea, 89 in Carmel Valley, and 86 in Big Sur. That's pretty good stuff. Another record, 87 in Salinas. Then you go into the 90s from Gonzales all the way to King City, 95 degrees. Lows still in the 40s, though. Still good sleeping weather. Got up to 90 at Hollister, 88 Morgan Hill Gilroy, and a couple of degrees cooler in San Jose. So the warmth we promised you happened. Hey, look at that first triple-digit number we've seen in a while, 101 in Palm Springs, 93 in Van Nuys, over the hill, Bakersfield, 90. Same for Fresno, Sacramento, and Redding. That doesn't happen every day. All four of those major stations, same temperature. Nice and warm on the coast in Southern California as well. Toasty in Phoenix, cooler to the north from Seattle to Denver, back up to Bismarck, Chicago, 59 today, 63 in New York, and then back into the 70s. And you got to get all the way to South Florida to get back into the 80s. So we're actually warmer than a lot of parts of the country today. Meanwhile, cold front's beginning to find its way out to the Atlantic. Most of the southeast has gotten through with it. No severe weather with this, unlike what we had a week ago, just a whole bunch of rain. But of course, a lot of flooding still in the Midwest, another system bringing more rain in. That one could spawn a few more big thunderstorms later on this week. We're keeping an eye on that, see if we'll get more tornadoes out of it. It is a season, after all, and May can turn out to be a violent month, but so far it's been relatively quiet. Next cold front going up in the Pacific Northwest, no bother for you. That will continue to move that way. We get this front to move through here, but most of the rain will stay up the upper Midwest. Upper level lows stays all over the East Coast, keeping them cooler than normal. We'll probably fire up some thunderstorms around St. Louis by about this time tomorrow night. But for the rest, pretty easy going. Traveling across the map for the next couple days, relatively comfortable. High pressure ridge will begin to ease down a little bit up in the upper levels of the atmosphere. And by the weekend, a couple of high clouds. Another cold front and an upper level low looks like it's going to dive down. We may see some showers, hit and miss stuff up in Northern California, but I don't think we'll see anything down here except a bunch of clouds, both low stuff and high stuff over the weekend, but I don't think we'll see rain on Mother's Day. Meanwhile, we get that onshore flow in the morning, offshore in the morning, then onshore, and then back to the onshore flow there, and that'll start that cooling process, start seeing cooling temperatures already by Friday evening. Likely also include some of that fog starting to set up there. That'll kind of start the natural air conditioning. So this is actually only for really a couple of days of warmth, and then we bring it down to something actually closer to normal. So we're a little bit above normal, but still good for a bunch of 80s and even a few 90s in the Bay Area, the Santa Clara Valley, and the Salinas Valley. But the differences start to get more widespread. 76 looks like a good guess for Salinas, which is more coastal than inland. By the time you get Gonzales, you're in the 90s there, or at least close to it tomorrow, with overnight lows in the upper 40s and 50s. Upper 60s and a few 70s ought to do it in the peninsula. Carmel Valley, though, 85. Same for Ben Lomond, looks pretty well reasonable. And just a bit cooler along the north end of the bay, but still good weather for the beach. Clear and mild. We have that east to northeast wind running about 5 to 10 miles an hour, so no big blow there. And it'll pick up a little bit tomorrow afternoon, but still pretty comfortable. Mild bayside, sunny and warm to hot, depending on your definition, for the valleys. But I think by Friday we start seeing some of that fog locally into the Salinas Valley and all along the coast, cooling everybody down a little bit, stronger sea breeze. That'll get you upper 60s and 70s for the valleys and the mountains on the weekend until probably about Tuesday, Wednesday, when things start moving up into the 70s again. And along the beaches, it will cool down, and we'll probably even see a few upper 50s and 60s with some night and morning fog and low clouds. Sunday could see high clouds linger a little longer, so a little different tinge on there, but still a nice weekend.
Yeah.
No problems there. Yeah, considering
just
the alternatives.
Gorgeous. Yeah. Just beautiful.
Beautiful. Great stuff.